Cuts and consequences in state government as the governor is up against a deadline tomorrow to sign the state budget. A new language in a budget bill now up for debate at the state capitol would have children losing as many as 20 days of the school year. The bill calls for longer lasting cuts to education than first outlined in Governor Brown's May budget. And KCRA3's Mike Lurie live for us at the capitol to explain all this. Mike.
Well, Golston, let me show you the budget bill that directly affects schools not just for 1 year, but for two. It involves trigger cuts that would change the school calendar from 180 days currently to down to 160 days if voters reject Governor Brown's tax hike proposal in November.
It's fair to say that since we're cutting so many school days, we're not going to learn as much.
Students we met today at the Capitol were stunned to learn their school year may be getting shorter by 3 weeks.
That's actually devastating because, like, our education is actually getting lowered.
Teachers we talked to are also upset.
Cutting on the academics is not going to help. It doesn't help the student, the families that have to supervise those kids out of the classroom for more time.
Republican lawmakers like Beth Gaines, also a mother of six, said California is moving in the wrong direction.
Education should be our priority. We cannot try to solve this budget crisis on the backs of parents and families and kids.
But with California nearly $16 billion in debt, Democrats say voters will know exactly what's at stake if they say no to new taxes in November.
Our $92 billion general fund budget will be reduced to about $85 billion. About $5.5 billion will impact public education. So this just reflects the facts of life if we don't have that revenue in November.
Who can blame you for that?
Yet that tax hike is a toss-up at best. But education consistently ranks as a top priority with California voters. And Democrats are banking on it.
Well, the Senate Budget Committee is meeting right now to approve those changes in the bill, and they're expected to do that just in a couple of hours. They'll be back tomorrow as the full Senate and full Assembly meet to vote on the entire budget trailer package, starting at 9 o'clock, and then, of course, it goes to Governor Brown, who has until midnight tomorrow night to either sign or veto these measures. Reporting live in the state capitol, Mike Lurie, KCRA 3 reports.
Mike, any indication right now at this hour about what the governor might do?
Yeah, the governor certainly expected to sign these packages. After all, he did meet in consultation with the two top Democratic leaders. But it's also likely that he'll take out his blue pencil to trim maybe hundreds of millions of dollars in additional spending.
All right. Mike Lurie, appreciate that.